It's Ben with another important safety topic. In this video, I want to talk about how to use a bench grinder safely. Before we get into the details, let's start with an introduction to what a bench grinder does. A bench grinder, which is sometimes referred to as a pedestal grinder, works by rapidly spinning abrasive wheels to grind, sharpen, or polish metal surfaces. You can use it on just about any metal tool that needs sharpening, including chisels, scissors, knives, drill bits, punches, and screwdrivers. A typical bench grinder has two wheels on either side of the motor housing. Usually, one wheel is hard for grinding and the other wheel is soft for polishing. Most of the wheel is covered by a guard, but about one quarter is exposed. An eye shield is mounted at the top of this section and a work rest is mounted at the bottom. Most grinding wheels spin at 3,000 to 3,600 RPM. Now that you know what a bench grinder does, let's go over how to use it. To begin, we'll talk about the essential safety features of the bench grinder. The most important is the work rest. The work rest provides an anchor point for you to rest your material so that it stays level and sturdy as you grind. The work rest must always be adjusted to a 1/8 inch gap from the wheel. This is to minimize the risk of an object getting caught in the wheel. Never use a bench grinder with a gap greater than 1/8 of an inch, as the injuries from getting caught in the wheel will be very serious. Next, there is a tongue guard located at the top of the wheel. This guard blocks any debris from being carried over by the wheel and shot out at the user. The tongue guard must be spaced 1/4 inch from the wheel. At this distance, there is minimal risk of debris slipping through the gap being ejected from the machine. The easiest way to measure and adjust the gaps on the work rest and tongue is with a gap gauge. You can find the gap gauges specifically made for the bench grinder online. At ASC, gap gauges can be found attached to the pedestal of all bench grinders. Use the gauge to check the work rest and tongue guard before starting the machine. If the gap needs adjustment, simply loosen the bolts with an Allen wrench, make the adjustment, and retighten the bolts. At ASC, Allen wrenches can also be found attached to the pedestal of all bench grinders. Importantly, always make sure the machine is off and the wheels are still before adjusting the grinder. And if you can't adjust the work rest or tongue guard to the necessary gap, your wheel is too small and needs to be replaced. The next safety feature on a bench grinder is one to protect your eyes from the sparks created while grinding. Not surprisingly, this is called a spark shield. These spark shields are located above the tongue guard and are used to block sparks and debris from flying towards your face. A spark shield should be angled so that it covers the wheel. Spark shields will sometimes loosen and move over time, so make sure yours is tight and in the right position before starting your task. If it becomes difficult to see through, simply wipe it off with a wet cloth or rag, though if that doesn't work, call maintenance for a replacement. Let's talk about clothing and PPE required for using a bench grinder. Before getting started, check to make sure you're not wearing any loose or dangling clothing. Take off loose welding gloves, tie back long hair, and remove any jewelry you have on. Next, whenever a tool generates sparks and flying debris, you'll need safety glasses and a face shield to protect your eyes and face. And because we use our bench grinders in a shop environment, you'll also need a hard hat and hearing protection. Once you have the right clothing and PPE, you'll be ready to get started. Here are some instructions to keep in mind when operating the grinder. When grinding small material, don't hold it directly with your hand. There's no need to get that close to the wheel. Instead, use locking pliers or clamps to hold the material. Never grind on the side of the wheel. This will damage it and risk sending debris flying when the wheel breaks apart. Only grind on the square or front-facing side of the wheel. Keep a cup of water near the grinder to cool the material as you work. You'll know the steel is overheating if it starts to turn bluish black. To avoid ruining the edge of a tool by overheating it, dip the material in water every 10 to 15 seconds on the grinder. Once you've finished your task and turned off the wheel, the wheel will continue to spin. This could be a hazard to others walking by. To make the wheel fully stop once the grinder is turned off, Lightly press the wheel dresser or a piece of metal against the wheel until it stops spinning. As the wheel is used, the spaces between the cutting grit can become clogged. The grit can become dull and the wheel will develop grooves. A wheel in this condition will not be effective. To fix a dull or grooved wheel, use a wheel dresser. Start the bench grinder and wait for it to reach full speed. Then, press the wheel dresser against the spinning wheel, holding it perpendicular to the face of the wheel. Apply light pressure and grind away the surface. This will expose new grit and square the face of the wheel, removing the grooves. That's it for this video on the proper use and safe practices of the bench grinder. Remember to always be cautious when working around powerful tools. So stay safe, have a great week, and I'll see you next time.